Welcome to St. James Plantation's Event Spotlight. A sea town, a hometown, a timeless way of life.
It's kind of like playing cards, only with tiles. Instead of having spades, hearts, and diamonds, clubs, you have cracks, dots, and bams. The big difference, I think, between cards and playing mahjong is that in American mahjong, you have to make your hand be one of the hands that's indicated on a card. And that's the hard part. You can't create it from scratch. You have to try and create a hand that matches something that already exists.
And we have some trouble sometimes remembering from previous years.
Yeah, each year the card changes.
And I think, well, there's a lot of strategy involved. There's also a lot of luck involved.
Yes.
The jokers are a big part of the luck.
They make the difference, yeah.
What is our mantra? 60% luck, 40% skill? Sometimes it's more than that. There's actually a lot of individual groups going on teaching new people. It's a lot like anything. You can't learn it in one or two sessions, but if you keep at it and you practice, it's not that hard to learn. A lot of people in neighborhoods will teach other people who want to learn.
That's usually the best way to get started is you come in as a substitute and you offer the substitute for different groups. And then you also see how the dynamics work out and then which group is best suited to the way you like to play. Because as I said before, some people are more serious than others. And usually that's how you get to become a regular.
Right. There are mahjong groups that play in homes. There are neighborhood mahjong groups. There are actually mahjong groups every day of the week, morning and afternoon, and evening at the community center. And there are women's groups, and then there are mixed groups like this one.
We're a fun-loving group here, and we don't take it real seriously. Some people play this, and it's very serious, but we're here just to have fun and to be social with each other. But, you know, we like to win if we can.